With a normal swallow, food and liquids move from the mouth into the esophagus directed by a precise sequence of coordinated muscle movements. However, the presence of a tongue tie and/or a high palate disrupts the sequence by making it much more challenging for the tongue to initiate an efficient and effective swallow. A normal swallow requires a smooth progression of four stages: oral preparatory stage, oral transit stage, pharyngeal stage, and esophageal stage. During the oral preparatory stage, food is kept in the front part of the mouth where it is moistened with saliva and chewed into a softer consistency. Once the food bolus has been processed by the mouth, the oral transit stage begins with the tongue raising up against the hard palate while the back of the tongue drops to allow the bolus to move into the back of the mouth. Simultaneously, the soft palate raises up against the back while closing off the passageway into the nose, preventing any food or liquids from regurgitating up into the nose. However, when a high palate is present, the tongue has greater difficulty in initiating the oral transit phase because the tongue is unable to raise up against the hard palate as well. As such, the food bolus is unable to effectively and efficiently move to the back of the mouth. When a tongue tie is present, a similar challenge to swallow occurs as the tongue is stuck to the bottom of the mouth, preventing it from elevating up against the hard palate. Release of the tongue tie, if present, allows for greater tongue mobility. If a high palate is present, oral motor tongue exercises can help both strengthen and improve tongue flexibility to compensate for the high palate. The pharyngeal stage is a rapid sequential activity during which the bolus is propelled into the esophagus. The larynx elevates while the epiglottis flips down, protecting the airway. Not clearly shown are the pharyngeal muscles, which contract, squeezing the bolus downward. The cricopharyngeus muscle, or upper esophageal sphincter, relaxes and opens to allow food and liquids to pass into the esophagus. Occasionally, if the oral transit stage does not properly occur due to a high palate and/or tongue tie, choking or gagging may happen as the bolus may prematurely spill into the throat before the pharyngeal stage is ready to commence. Once the bolus passes the cricopharyngeus muscle, the esophageal stage begins. The cricopharyngeus muscle closes back up to prevent any regurgitation back up into the throat. The esophageal muscles continue to propel the bolus into the stomach via coordinated muscle contraction and relaxation known as peristalsis. The mouth and throat resets to prepare for the next swallowing event.